sports. It's in the game.
Get 1200. How mom sneezes.
Achoo.
How dad sneezes.
Achoo.
How sis sneezes.
Achoo.
How bro sneezes.
Achoo.
How grandpa sneezes. How mom.
This young fan was throwing a baseball in the stands and decided to give it away to a girl sitting behind him who was clearly not expecting it. And I.
Spent all my money, please give me a free slushy cup.
You don't even follow us or like our videos.
So what?
So no free slushy cup for you.
How to play Fortnite like a pro? Let's go! Like this!
Thank you.
order to keep my gremlin count up, I only usually like shower like once a month.
Bro.
Let's go! Another crown win! Oh my god!
Set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup, and these guys on your screen ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game, and speaking of the game, let's get right to it. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Seattle. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now Fields, rolling to his right. He's got a man complete. The 20. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Carroll in that familiar hands-on-knees pose. His guys will go for two here. They'll look to throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Ron Thornhill. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. So they went for two and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Throwing on first down is Brady. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
A former rushing champ, a 3-time All-Pro, it's Priest Holmes. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6. On 2nd down and 4, Brady. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that'll bring up a 3rd down. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. He's got his tight end. It's Tommy Tremble. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play there for the Dolphins.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
On 1st down, it's Holmes. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. The 1st down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. The false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on 2nd down. Now a play fake. Brady, they'll roll him out right. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Tommy Tremble there to make the grab. And the Dolphins have tied it. Now they can take the lead with the extra point. Morton Anderson now for the extra point. It's up and good, so they go the conservative route instead, and it gets them a 7-6 lead here in the opening quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone and beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right in your playbook,
it's that easy here. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Sliding out of the pocket. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that is incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. And that'll bring up second down. Off play action, Fields. They'll get it to Irvin, right side complete. And I think the ball's out, and this is picked up by the Dolphins.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball, you know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. This offense thankful, I'm sure, to have the football back, but also, Charles, after a long drive of their own, they've got to be a little... And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Play action, now it's Brady. Steps away. Open man left side, it's the tight end Trimble. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. On third down, Holmes fighting his way through contact. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. Chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
The last run got six, now second and four. On play action, now Brady. He'll buy some time right. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. On the carry, it's Holmes. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The last run got 9, that leaves him with second and a yard. On play action, it's Brady. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. And Brady's throw there, incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Anderson's kick is good. And they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for 3.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them 3. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last 2 drives.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time they coughed it up. Led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. They bring the safety on the blitz, and he busts through to drop him for an 8-yard loss. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Rolling to his right. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And it looked like he got the feet down, did he? Yes, it's a catch. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Justin Jefferson, 85 yards. And the Seahawks on just 2 plays have taken the lead. They'll try and throw for it. They'll roll him out right. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. So now, Charles, two touchdowns, two tries, and two-point conversions, and both fail.
And you want to say, let's go ahead and run the kicker out there from now on, but the problem is you're chasing points at this stage. So now you got to dial up your two-point conversions and hope you're successful from here on out.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And after the field goal last time, see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
And he'll have a Dolphins first down as he's able to get this up to the 37-yard line. They'll run on first down. It's Holmes, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. On first down, Holmes. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 22. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line.
Man, I'm not going to tell him that you called him old in our pregame meeting, but this guy has been around a long time. If there's a trick in the book, he knows it. He probably even wrote a few chapters. And this is what he's always had, and that's a nose for the football. He's able to come away here with the interception.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Shot before the break. Fields sliding out of the pocket. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Now a handoff here to his running back. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Holmes, and they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They'll run on first down. Holmes. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
105 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Now Brady. Escaping the pressure right. A little check down to Lindsey. Short completion, just 4 yards. And that is going to set up a third and 1.
This red zone is where the Seahawk crowd really makes it tough for an offense to communicate. It's third down.
Brady going to throw. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3. This stadium once registered as the loudest roar ever recorded, and you can hear him now, third and goal. Yeah, boy, a good surge defensively. It'll depend on the mark, but I'm not sure he got there. Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal. They're going to run this with a tight end.
And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Pat Freiermuth. Excellent work there to get in on the touchdown run. And the Dolphins are going to jump back in front. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the lead is up to five. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Play action. It's Fields. He'll buy some time right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they...
He's got it! Touchdown, Dolphins! Cooper Kupp there to make the grab. And the Dolphins use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. We sit in quarter number three out in Seattle. A second and 10 now. Here's Fields. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. A play fake, now Fields to throw. Rolling to his right. That's complete to his tight end, Freiermuth. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And it'll be fourth down. They snap it to Fields. They'll roll him out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle. A false start backs him up five, first and 15.
Bunch formation, bunch formation. Come on, boys, come on.
One play action. Fields sliding out of the pocket. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
On second down, Cook. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up
first downs.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. A shotgun snap, Fields. And complete, right side to Cook. Just a gain of a couple there. And they're going to have a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it can turn into a big game downfield. What a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
Give him 4 yards on the play, and that will lead us into the two-minute warning. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. Touchdown, Seahawks! Dalvin Cook from 4 yards out. And the Seahawks have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. He'll look to throw. He'll buy some time right. And he will get into the end zone to cut the deficit down to four. So the signal caller doing it himself there on the two-point try.
You gotta like that. We always talk about the ball staying in the hands of the best players. But most of the time, you want to get it to a back, pitch it to a wide receiver. In this case, the quarterback did it himself.
And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And this one now not quite over yet. Still two timeouts remaining defensively. And boy, having that third timeout would have really helped here.
Yeah, another example of why coaches really stress saving your timeouts for when you absolutely have to have them. They go over this all the time. Here's one of those situations.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And a 6-yard gain gets them right around the 43. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves them with 1 yard to go on third down. So here we go, Charles, third down. Any chance you're throwing?
I don't think so. I think you got to keep the clock rolling here.
And indeed, they will keep it on the ground. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to convert, albeit not by much, on third and a yard. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. And they take a knee. Victory very likely now for the Dolphins as they take a knee here. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. Steps away to his left. Now he'll square up and throw deep left sideline. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. And one last throw here for Fields. Rolling to his right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play. And this ball game is over. Well, Charles, a pretty exhilarating finish to the end of this ball game. At the end, the Hail Mary prayers, though, they went unanswered. Could have won it, but couldn't get it done.
Almost fell schoolyard.